Hello everyone, this is Priyanka Mohite. In 2013, I got opportunity to climb Mount Everest. I was hardly 20 or 21 year old, and after successfully climbing on 22nd May 2013, there was a big question ahead me that what next. So I decided to climb this 14,000 meter mountains, and then I took a challenge of Mount Lhotse, which is exactly near to Mount Everest. And 2018, I climbed Mount Lhotse. Unfortunately, in 2014 and 2015, I was not able to climb Mount Lhotse, where I tried to climb it, but once because of earthquake, and once because of the huge avalanche where 17 Sherpas died at a time in the Khumbu ice wall, so I was not able to climb. But yes, 2018 I climbed Mount Lhotse. After that, I took a challenge to climb Mount Makalu. In 15 May 2019, I climbed Makalu, and Makalu is really technical mountain. A combination of a wind, blue ice, and rocks. Yes, so it was a really different challenge, and I submitted successfully and came back, and my expedition was really amazing. Then 2020, I wanted to climb Mount Kanchenjunga, which is our highest mountain, but I was not able to climb because of this COVID pandemic. Not only me, but everyone, no one able to climb because of this COVID pandemic. So then I decided, okay, let's go in 2021. But unfortunately, Kanchenjunga is a teamwork. We need huge team. So very few climber, two or three, wanted to attempt. But so the expedition got cancelled. So I moved to Mount Annapurna. I was like, okay, Annapurna known as the deadliest mountain. And behind the success of Annapurna, I will say the mostly are Sherpas who fixed the rope, and especially Mi'kmaqji and Mi'kmaq Tenzi, who are kings of fixing route above 8,000 meters, who already opened the route for K2 winter ascent. And we were really blessed and lucky that they were there in the expedition. And all 69 people climbed it, and there was no a single casualty. About Annapurna, Annapurna is a combination of very bad weather. Actually, you can't trust the weather, especially. And then deep snow, blue ice. It's a technical climb, especially majorly above camp 2, the all technicality and avalanche prone area. So many avalanche prone areas are there. You have to be very careful, have to wear proper gear, always helmets, and then you have to be always ready for any circumstances. And there was a really big challenge about camp 2 to reach camp 3. And camp 3 was on the Serac, and it was really horrible to sleep in the night. We can hear the noise that something is falling every time. Above camp 3, there was a huge wall we have to climb, overhang wall with our front point and the Zumar. And after that, there is a combination of blue eye, combination of a deep snow, and we have to go reach camp 4. And after that, we decided to climb on 15 April. Unfortunately, because of the shortage of rope, we were not able to climb on 15. And next day, as our Sherpa fixed the route, and all 69 climbers climbed on a 16 April. And we all came safely to base camp. Though it is known as a deadliest mountain, the rate is really low, but this time there was a single casualty, which is a really amazing thing in a mountain. And people are injured, but no one died. So I had a really amazing experience. So, as I said, I will continue climbing those remaining 8,000 meter mountain where I have finished 4. So mostly next year I'll go for Mount Kanchenjunga. And it requires a lot of mental health and physical health. One more important part is acclimatization procedure. Your health is really important. So if you are very well acclimatized in a mountain, and you have a good strength, and you have a very good mental strength, you can easily climb mountains. And so for this Annapurna, I really want to give the credit to all the Sherpas who opened and fixed the route for all the climbers, and that's why people climber can summit and came back safely. And thank you so much.